Posita, the chair recognize Congresswoman Jinky Luistro. Go ahead, ma'am.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I wish to address my question to Attorney Harry Roque. With all due respect, Attorney, Mr. Chair, this is a common knowledge that Attorney Harry Roque worked as the spokesperson for former President Rodrigo Roa Duterte. Does our resource speaker confirm this?
Yes, Madam Chair. Mr. Chair.
And Mr. Chair, can we please direct the resource speaker to describe ano po ba ang trabaho ng isang resource speaker ng presidente?
As spokesperson, I was addressing the Malacañang Press Corps 3 times a week. I was preparing press releases on behalf of the president, and I was answering queries from the media on behalf of the president.
And will the resource speaker agree if I would say that a spokesperson position is a position of trust and confidence?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And by position of trust and confidence, it means that the president is giving you his full trust and confidence in all matters that might be within or even relevant to the discharge of your function as presidential spokesperson. Does the resource speaker agree?
Mr. Chairman, subject to regular consultations with the president.
And for the information of the committee, by the position of trust and confidence, it means that the moment the president lost the trust and confidence to the person, he can anytime terminate this official.
I confer that, Mr. Chairman. I was appointed to a position with the rank of cabinet member.
I understand as well that Attorney Roque is one of the seasoned lawyers, as a matter of fact, internationally. Can you please enlighten us on your background as a lawyer?
I have been teaching international law in UP, as well as in American University and National University of Singapore, total of more than 20 years already until now. And I was past president of the Asian Society of International Law. I'm also a member of the List Council of the International Criminal Court.
And having earned that reputation in the legal circle, Mr. Chair, and being the presidential spokesperson as well, I would assume that if ever there will be erroneous decisions on the part of the president, Attorney Harry Roque will be calling the attention and correcting or perhaps stopping the president from pursuing such erroneous action. Will the resource speaker agree to this?
I do not think I had that function. I could only speak for the president. I could not actually countermand him. I could not correct him. He is my principal.
But considering, Mr. Chair, that he is a lawyer and a spokesperson as well, pagka ho ba may maling desisyon ang presidente, will you not volunteer your legal expertise to correct the president?
Unless I am asked for my opinion, Mr. Chair, I will not volunteer, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, I wish to invite the attention of Attorney Harry Roque to PD 1869. This is described as the Charter of PAGCOR. And as a matter of fact, it defines what illegal gambling is. I also wish to invite his attention to Republic Act No. 9487, which extends the franchise of PAGCOR to another 25 years. Again, it defines what illegal gambling is. Ultimately, Mr. Chair, I wish to invite the attention of Attorney Roque to Executive Order No. 13. And I wish to state for the record, Mr. Chair, that for the very first time, the term online gaming was mentioned in Executive Order Number 13. This is something which is not mentioned, which is not provided in PD 1869 as well as in RA 9487. May I ask the resource speaker, when the President issued Executive Order Number 13, don't you think he legislated?
I am unable to make an opinion because when I was a spokesperson, legal matters such as these are directed to the Presidential Legal Counsel or to the Office of the Solicitor General or to the Legal Office of the Office of the President under the Executive Secretary.
Mr. Chair, this representation wishes to solicit the opinion of a legal expert, our resource speaker, Attorney Harry Roque. I am sure that with the number of hearings he went through already, he has come across Executive Order Number 13. This is the presidential issuance during the time of former President Rodrigo Roa Duterte mentioning the term online gaming for the very first time. The term that was never mentioned in PD 1869 and even in RA 9487. I hope we can be enlightened by the legal expertise of our resource speaker. When the President issued EO number 13, providing for the term online gaming for the very first time, don't you think, Attorney Roque, that the President legislated?
Again, Your Honor, I am unable to answer because that is not within my expertise. I have mentioned that my expertise is in the field of public international law, having taught and practiced that. And I am sorry because I'm not very familiar with Executive Order Number 13. In fact, my only knowledge of Executive Order Number 13 was in the last hearing when former Chair Domingo said that President Duterte regulated online gambling, no, through Executive Order Number 13. But I am unable to give an opinion now, not being thoroughly familiar with the EO as well as the underpinnings behind the issuance of Executive Order Number 13. I'm so sorry, Your Honor, it's not within my field of expertise.
With all due respect to our resource speaker, Mr. Chair, I find it strange na sa dami po ng hearing na ina-attendan niya, both in the Senate and in the Congress, all pertaining to POGOs, he have not come across EO Number 13. From which the POGOs or the online gaming started. But I'm sure for the next concern that I wish to raise, our resource speaker is very much familiar with, because this is fundamental in the study of law. There is in law the principle of separation of powers. And I wish to share the case of Belgica versus Ochoa, GR number 208566, November 19, 2013, on the constitutionality of the Priority Development Assistance Fund. For the information of the Filipino people, I wish to read. The principle of separation of powers refers to the constitutional demarcation of the three fundamental powers of the government. In the celebrated words of Justice Laurel Inangara versus Electoral Commission, it means that the Constitution has blocked out, with deft strokes and in bold lines, allotment of power to the executive, the legislative, and the judicial departments of the government. To the legislative branch of the government, through Congress, belongs the power to make laws. To the executive branch of the government through the president belongs the power to enforce laws. To the judicial branch of government through the court belongs the power to interpret laws. I wish to go back to Attorney Roque. Attorney Roque, don't you think that the president encroached upon the power of the Congress when he issued Executive Order Number 13 providing for online?
Well, Mr. Chair, first and foremost, I argued that case of Belica. I was lawyer in the Supreme Court for Mr. Belica, and I confirmed the principle of separation of powers. However, as I said, although it is not my expertise, I will give my opinion, my candid opinion. And that is, under our scheme of things, executive issuances, legislative enactments are all presumed to be constitutional unless proven otherwise. So the status of Executive Order Number 13, unless challenged in court, is that it is presumed to be constitutional. Executive orders being the nature of implementing existing legislation, Your Honors.
Mr. Chair, there's a principle in law. When the law does not provide, we should not provide. When the law does not include, we should not include. If the substantive law creating PAGCOR does not provide for online gaming, then no executive issuances should provide for online gaming. Let us all be reminded by the Litan legal maxim, inclusio unius est exclusio alterius. Kung wala naman pong sinabi dun sa substantive law, then the procedural law should not provide. Let us be reminded that the procedural law should always yield in favor of the substantive law. Mr. Chair, I wish to invite the attention of the committee to Executive Order Number 13, the Presidential